man that I remember. The first time ever I see the booty. For this summer evening.
On today's Explore Corner, we're going to document how a Shakespeare Mas Crown is made. We know that Shakespeare Mas is unique to Karaku. As a matter of fact, Karaku is the only place in the entire world you'll see this type of mass portrayed. Colorfully dressed masqueraders reciting the lines of William Shakespeare from the book of Julius Caesar. With the fumble of a line, he receives a whip on his back, which is protected by what is referred to as a crown. And today, we're going to document how a crown is made. And this is Miss Marty. Miss Marty, you good? Millicent Thomas, aka Miss Marty.
Yeah.
I could say that?
Yes.
And Miss Marty has been sewing uniforms for Jeremiah and other masqueraders for the past plenty years. Miss Marty, how are you doing?
Good.
You good?
Yeah.
How many years now you're sewing Shakespeare masks?
A long time, 30 years.
Yeah, around that.
Yes.
About 30 years.
Yeah.
That's when Jeremiah started playing.
Yes.
You're proud of him, right?
Oh yes.
How is it sewing for you? Is it a lot of work or?
Not really, because I sew for Harvey Bill children.
I sew for them.
And they appreciate me very
well. Lovely. Nice, Miss Marty. So you go show them how to make the thing?
Yeah.
The crown?
Yes. I stitch the crown.
Nice.
I stitch it for them.
Lovely. Yeah. Jerry, yes. Give me a line now.
Give me a go. Wherefore is Joyce what comfort bring you home? What Jimmy Terry found you to room?
Break what?
To where's the captive bones of China to wear?
I said break man.
Black you stones you was on a
brave man.
Well, you are not your cruel man.
Brave man.
Well, you are pumping many a time.
Brave man.
If you climb up to walls and battlements.
Brave man.
To towers and windows.
Brave man.
Yeah, to children. In front of your arm, dead shuffling glasses.
Brave boy.
With patient expectation.
Brave boy.
To see the great pumping back to the streets of
war. Stop, boy.
And when you saw his chariot butter
pierce.
Have you not made a universal shot? That timber tremble on the nature banks. To hear the replication of your songs. Made in your comfy of shoes.
Brave
you know put on the best attire.
Well,
you know call out an army.
Brave one.
You know two flowers in his way.
Brave
that comes in trouble.
Brave one.
Be gone. Be gone.
For
on your knees.
Brave
to your God and into make the pledge. That made the most light in this country. Brave
one.
Yeah, Jerry, you're back. So, of course, you know that Jerry's a Shakespeare Mas player. Jerry, how long are you playing Shakespeare?
Boy, a very long time, you know. That is easy. More than 30 years.
Nice. And Basie is a backer. And when I say a backer is someone who?
Well, from creation, you have to start preparing. The backer always there to make sure that the cutter is properly picked. We're going to show that another time. A crown is properly made.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, Miss Thomas is responsible for the petticoat and your Shakespeare outfit. But today, a backer's role is preparing the crown because Jerry as king, just to make, you know, just to add to the story, Jerry may not be the king.
Yeah.
Could have been Shankai. Or elf, or yeah, different man have different role.
Yeah.
But today Jerry is the king, so the backer always prepares the king's outfit at the top level. So today we're going to show you how the crown is being prepared. Yeah, so you buy whatsoever cloth you want, how you think you want to look. You do that. You cloth. You prepare your cloth. 3/4 of the time the cloth come from Grenada, which is easy to get. But you have a fairy godmother like ours would send you pretty cloths. Miss Lydia and June. George Andrew, Miss Louisa Primus. Yeah, just to name a few. Who is into Shakespeare, dude, send clocks down. Yeah, and today we're going to show you few processes into the crown making.
Put your arm around it. Okay.
All right. So this is one of the rule of the backer. Now your clot could be whatever width you want to be, depending on your size. So if you have a little man like me, my crown would be little. A big man like Jerry, your crown would be big. Yeah? Alright, we there.
Nice. Set like that, right? Mm-hmm. And you pin it to reach here. And the fly. So this will be flying. As well, this will be flying as well. Right.
Nice.
So this is your tail. This is one you have to hold.
There you go.
And there we go.
Nice.
Okay, man.
So this is the part. The first part was the part of the cloth. Cutting. This is the cutting of the paper. With your crown, you must have paper. Yeah? And your paper would include the best paper you could find is cement bags. The empty cement bags or the reused cement bag you get by our cement production people. So the cement bag should go, and you have to buy it, folks. You go to Paddy's or Bullins and ask them for cement bags. I mean, Paddy's and Mr. Bullin, good, them would contribute bags to the Shakespearean because it's our culture. Yeah? So the cutting of the bag. And remember, you're doing this because you want the king or the peacemaker to be very properly attired.
That's it.
Yeah? And they go
one by one.
They got one by one.
Alright, that's right. That's it.
Yeah, one by one. Mm-hmm. Cock ring and we'll choose the money day the pattern.
Yeah.
Alright.
So
what
now?
So we have, and a good Shakespearean would use 5 to 6 bags.
God is good every day. Morning, noon, and night. God is good.
This next process now is after you end the cloth, you stitch the cloth.
That's
this
right.
Is just the stitching.
That's right.
We need to string what you call to tie the that's hair to right. The cutter.
That's right.
So basically, everybody know how to string the cutting. Mm-hmm. When Christmas comes here, to know how to string the cutting. Mm-hmm. You know how to do that, well, you have a problem.
Oh, yes.
Well, I have a problem right there.
Who made the
shredding of the head of the crown?
Make a knot, you know.
Yeah, you make a knot. Not so you can't run through.
Yeah, so just...
And if you run through, you could stop it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That case is to when you tie it, yeah, right, to keep it up, the cutter form.
Yeah.
That's it. That's why we have it that way. So we could, and then we take, put one on top.
Mm-hmm.
And then you put the next one down here. So.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So then after you do the same, right, it's like this, then you come back again. And this one up again. And you put the next one right here again.
Yeah, for when you have to receive your legs.
Yeah, that's your legs part.
No, when you
yes.
When you
words
is not right.
Right. That's it. That's it. It goes like this. Yes. Come on.
Bring a little thing here, Jerry. There we go. Yeah.
And then they put a short piece there.
And
yeah, and leave that tail too.
Yeah, leave it.
Yeah, fly.
And nice. And then we starch.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, that's it. Yes. That is the end of it.
Yeah. Well, this is it. This is the most interesting part. Putting on the starch. And the starch means it comes from cassava.
That's right.
That you go when you don't know.
It's then?
Yes.
Yes.
You tell them? That you go to the cassava production area.
Yeah.
Where they go and do firing.
Yes.
And then you, when they press it, when the water.
The water, you collect that.
And then you sit and set.
Yeah.
And you set. And you set.
You have that there and you're waiting.
Yeah, and you drain it out. And then you have this starch. You put it to dry.
Put it to dry.
And then you have it.
And you have it waiting. Yeah. So this starch would stay there.
Stay as long as?
As long as 100 years.
Yeah.
And come Shakespeare, 2 days, 3 days before Shakespeare, you boil your starch. Like how we boil it now, but now we pour it out in this.
Mm-hmm.
And we have it there.
Put them on, put them.
Yeah. Because it's all boiled. Once it doesn't go cold, it'll be perfect. Once it go cold, that means it's as hard as zebra pig. You know why zebra pig? You go learn.
Okay.
It's a lot of work. Of course it's a lot of work. That's why the whole community comes out and make this a reality. So just think about it. You have 12 persons playing mass in the community of 6 year olds and thief alone. You have to do this. And then you go to Brunswick and help.
Right.
The ones in Brunswick, Montreal have a bigger contingent, so
the committee there.
This is a lot of work. I've seen the uniform sewn. The shirt sleeve. Sleeve has to be different, the neck has to be different, the body, the cutting up of the pieces of cloth to the front and sewing that. That is very timely again. Putting on the mirrors and the veils with the crown as you're doing now. This is like an entire day's work.
Exactly.
And the making of the kata, getting the roots of the Fiji and tying them together. It's a lot of work.
That is another process.
It's a lot of work.
Yeah, with the Fiji.
Fiji roots.
Yeah. So now the crown is prepared.
Alright.
And then
going like this.
And then you see the fasten.
Alright.
So when I draw, you're going to say, hold it, boy.
Alright. One more, boy. Give it. Give it again. One more. Go on.
Alright.
Alright.
That good?
One more, and that's it. Yes, I feel it well. Yes.
There you go.
I feel it, I feel it. Yes,
right.
Okay.
What are we
doing? Yeah, we're down there by the house.
Right.
We're going in the Fiji tree.
We're going right in the Fiji tree now, in the heart of the Fiji tree now.
Of course. And this tree is original.
Tree
that we get. Gone at the years with Shankai, Elfman, Uncle Sonny Boy, Uncle Alfred. Everybody come in and get the kata from. Yeah.
What is a kata? That is something you use to carry water?
No. It's, yeah, when it is folded, it looks like that. So, your kata is that
something like
that
this?
Wrong thing you place on your head
and a cut,
in Shakespeare.
Of course, it's like this.
That is the tree that
has
push all the buildings on one side, half side, across side, all they want. And when the tree die, the building fall?
Yeah. Now the tree will hold them. Yeah.
It's a banyan tree.
It's a banyan. Ah, there we go, Gary.
There's just one.
You know, while we were speaking about how laborious this is, we missed out the making of the bull.
Oh,
yeah.
No, you can't show that.
No,
a man only want to see how who making the whip to beat him when he forget the line.
Right, I agree.
Yeah.
Right.
So this
This is the formation of your kata.
That's right.
There's some like the one thick and strong, depending on your size and your hat and your head. Some man like Copperhead come in with a big kata.
Right, in Shakespeare Mass, tell us the purpose of the kata.
Yes, this kata is for. Should I go fold it like this? When you fold it like this?
As for holding the crown in place.
Yes. Right,
that's what I want to
hear. You have it.
So the kata is what holds the crown in place during the portrayal of Shakespeare. Right.
So everything is tied in place.
Right. Okay, that's good.
Jerry, I hold, you get the cloth. But in the meantime, I have my Caesar and I'm shipping out all the pieces. Yeah? So this is bad for the barber. That we are bad. If you need a trim, come by me.
You need one too?
We didn't.
Yeah, I ain't get the end yet. Let me make one more curve. Take that day.
Rain.
There is rain. No maroon coming. Yeah.
What date?
22nd of April. With the 6 roads maroon. Dumfries maroon. Correction.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Yeah.
Take from
the IT.
Whoop. I'll leave the piece for you.
When you go home, Jerry, form a piece.
And tighten.
Do another ring.
Mm-hmm. Right. Okay, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Right. So, Jerry, rest the cut on your head.
Yes. Hold it. Yeah. So you hold it like this.
Right.
Your cap is back.
Uh-huh.
And you have it form.
Right.
It's a cloth.
The
and the cloth, bring it deep, bring the back of me.
Yeah.
So,
just a wee.
My cap is back. And the cloth.
You have to use the proper cap.
Yep. This is not the right cap for it.
But.
And the cutter, settle there. Right. And
come with a piece of
the cloth, and time it on right below my chin.
Below your chin, and right. I tell him, I say, put your thumb in.
Right. That's right.
All right. There. So, next time we'll demonstrate how to dress a Shakespeare Mass player. Right. But the uniform consists of this, which is referred to as the kata, the back piece, which we just made, which is referred to as the crown, the shirt, that colorfully dressed shirt, with the black heart, which signifies the mood on that day, with the mirrors, the hulos, which attracts the crowd. Down to the petticoat, that white petticoat, the socks and the long boots, and the final thing on that day is the bullwhip. Right? So in future we'll show how a Shakespeare Mass player is dressed. Thank you very much for viewing this episode, and great job.